Boeing, a name that was once synonymous with the absolute zenith of engineering prowess and commitment to quality, and has long been recognized as the uncontested champion in civil aviation. Their aircrafts, revered for their innovative design and reliability, were a testament to their supremacy in the industry. But that all seems to be more and more in the past. So what happens when a giant, known for its excellence and dominance, stumbles? Hello friends, I hope you're having a fantastic day. Welcome to the Insight360 Europe edition. Today's video will be a little different from what you are used to. We will be examining the troubles at Boeing and how they're increasingly losing ground to their biggest competitor, Airbus. How can a company once synonymous with quality and safety lose its footing so quickly? Let's start with a quick look at the history of both companies so we get a better understanding of the monumental shift that is taking place in the aviation industry. Boeing was founded by William Boeing in a small boathouse in Seattle way back in 1916. It began its journey crafting seaplanes. Its first modern airliner, the Model 247, debuted in 1933. The Boeing 307 Stratoliner, introduced in the late 1930s, was the first commercial aircraft with a pressurized cabin, enabling high-altitude flight. The jet age of the 1950s saw Boeing introduce the revolutionary 707, reducing flight times and making air travel accessible. The iconic Boeing 747 launched in 1969 and transformed international travel, earning Boeing the market leader position in civil aviation. Competition grew in the 1990s, particularly with the rise of Airbus. Despite this, Boeing launched the successful 767 and the 777 models. The start of Airbus in the late 1960s was the complete opposite, as it was started as a European consortium, introducing its first aircraft, the A300, in 1972. The 1980s saw the strategic introduction of the A310 and the innovative A320. Airbus solidified its position in the market in the 1990s with the A330 and A340. The A380, the world's largest passenger airliner, was introduced in the new millennium, but changing market dynamics favored smaller, fuel-efficient jets. As a response, Airbus launched the successful A350XWB and expanded its single-aisle offerings with the A320neo family in the 2010s. The rivalry between Boeing and Airbus continues today, with contrasting strategies of scale versus efficiency. Over the years, Airbus and Boeing have emerged as each other's equals, commanding the commercial aviation market in a near duopoly that has seen both cooperation and intense rivalry. However, this rivalry took a dramatic turn in the late 2010s. Boeing faced significant challenges, most notably the two fatal crashes of its 737 MAX aircraft, which led to a worldwide grounding of the fleet and a crisis of confidence among airlines, regulators, and the public. The fallout from the 737 MAX crisis, coupled with management missteps and production issues, eroded Boeing's standing and financial performance. Meanwhile, Airbus capitalized on Boeing's misfortunes, securing orders for its A320neo family, which directly competes with the 737 MAX, and gaining ground in wide-body segments with the A350. When we look at orders in recent years, it's clear Boeing is losing ground fast. While the two crashes of the 737's MAX, by far the most dramatic recent events that characterize Boeing's current crisis, they are by far the only ones. Boeing, once revered as the pinnacle of aerospace engineering and safety, has found itself mired in a series of serious crises over the past 5 years, culminating in incidents that have shaken the world's trust in the company. From the horrifying details of fuselage parts blowing off mid-flight to revelations of sloppy workmanship and the tragic fatalities of 346 people in two crashes involving the 737 MAX, Boeing's reputation has dramatically shifted from a symbol of safety and innovation to one of caution and scrutiny. Some of the most damning negative publicity has been production issues with the Dreamliner since 2009, two fatal crashes of the 737 in 2018 and 2019, allegations of regulatory capture and oversight failures in 2018. Part of the fuselage blowing off shortly after takeoff, leaving a gaping hole in the plane in 2024. And just this week, Boeing has been hit by a damning report by the FAA regarding its safety culture, or lack thereof. The crises facing Boeing today stand in stark contrast from its former status as an industrial behemoth, celebrated for introducing the world to commercial jet travel, with a reputation so strong that people famously said, "If it's not Boeing, I'm not going." Critics and experts pinpoint a shift in corporate culture towards prioritizing profits over engineering, excellence, and safety. The merger with McDonnell Douglas, critics argue, marked a pivotal moment, steering Boeing away from its engineering roots towards a profit-driven approach. This shift was further exemplified by decisions to outsource production, rely heavily on suppliers, and move headquarters away from its manufacturing base, distancing leadership from the intricacies of aircraft production. Boeing's leadership in defense claims a renewed focus on quality and safety, with CEO Dave Calhoun highlighting efforts to instill a culture of transparency and rigorous quality processes. Yet, recent incidents like the Alaska Airlines 737 MAX fuselage blowout challenge these assurances, prompting federal probes and congressional hearings into Boeing's practices. Despite these challenges, Boeing insists on its commitment to quality, a stance met with skepticism by critics who argue that a deep-rooted cultural shift within the company over the past 25 years has undermined its legacy of safety and excellence. Boeing's financial struggles, marked by over $26 billion in cumulative net losses over 5 years, contrast sharply with its previous successes. These challenges, compounded by the 737 MAX crisis and the COVID-19 pandemic's impact, have placed Boeing squarely in second place against Airbus, which has outpaced Boeing in deliveries and orders, highlighting a dramatic shift in the aerospace industry's balance of power. Despite Boeing's ongoing challenges and the persistent emergence of quality and safety issues, the duopoly of the aerospace industry between Airbus and Boeing remains intact for now. However, Boeing's troubles could increase due to a rising competitor from China. COMAC and its C919 jet made a significant impact at the Singapore Air Show, marking the Chinese plane maker's first major international aviation event. The C919 attracted attention with orders from Tibet Airlines and Riyadh Air, positioning it as a potential rival to Boeing's 737 and the Airbus A320. As of this video's creation's date, the C919 has not yet received certification from the EASA or FAA, making it a less appealing option for Western carriers. However, this could change in the future. At this point, Boeing's future is uncertain. The company's continuous negative publicity is eroding trust with airlines and passengers, making it harder and harder to keep up with the competition. Despite reassurances from Boeing's management, the problems seem to be deeply rooted in the corporate culture and are not easily fixed. A visit to Boeing's corporate website shows that the company appears more focused on meeting DEI quotas than addressing the quality issues plaguing it, a choice many Western companies seem to be making nowadays. That's all for this week. We would love to hear your thoughts on Boeing's current situation. If there are any new updates, we will definitely keep you informed. We sincerely hope you enjoyed this episode, and we are really excited to see you again next week. Take care, and bye-bye.